Imagine being able to kick the flu quicker than you can say, achoo! And if you could find something that boosts your immune system, helping you to avoid many viruses, and that can also shorten the duration of the amount of time that you're sick, it's totally natural, and it also tastes so yummy that your family will beg you for more. Doesn't that sound dreamy during cold and flu season? Well, it truly is. And in this video, I'm going to share with you exactly why elderberry syrup may be the best remedy to have on hand so that you can kick the sickness with a quickness. If you love learning about herbs and how you can use them to keep yourself healthy and well, subscribe to my channel below, hit that little bell to be notified when a new video comes out. It's no secret that elderberry syrup is all the rage these days, and with great reason. It's an incredible immune booster, and it's true. It can actually help you kick the flu quicker than you can say achoo. Plus, with a pandemic happening, there is no better time to keep your immune system in check. We're only a few weeks into the school year where I live, and there's already reports of kids testing positive for COVID. And that's really scary, right? And I'm not here to say that elderberries will keep COVID away from you, but it is one fantastic way to really strengthen the immune system and get your hardworking immune army ready to attack any foreign invaders that may be trying to get into your body. So what makes elderberries so special to be used as the big guns in the home of an herbalist? One of the obvious reasons I already stated is that it's a great immune booster. But I think my favorite reason of all, though, is that it's really yummy medicine. And if you have kids, or if you have taste buds yourself, you certainly understand the importance of being able to make remedies that actually taste great and are still effective. Because the reality is, if they don't taste good, it's much harder to get people to take them, right? And when people don't take them, well, that's when people begin to think that herbs don't work. And they head off to the local drugstore to get whatever prescription or the over-the-counter meds that they can find. Ugh, yuck. In case you didn't know this yet, that's exactly what we're not going to do here, right? Because I mean, if you think about it, it was only the mid to late 1800s that the pharmaceutical industry began. And it began by extracting plant constituents and turning them into drugs that could help people. Pretty cool, right? But it really just helped the pharmaceutical company's wallet for the most part. But that's not what I'm here to talk to you about. I'm here to talk to you about elderberries and how they can help you through cold and flu season and strengthen your immune system. And of course, how they can be really yummy in the tummy. So those of you with kiddos, like me, you know how hard it can be to get your little ones or yourself to take their medicine, right? I always like to think of Mary Poppins and how she was really on to something when she said, "A spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. Medicine go down." Yeah, she was on it. Only I like to replace the refined sugar with a healthier alternative, like honey. Not only does honey replace the sugar well as a sweetener, it also helps to preserve the syrup. Anyways, about that immune boosting stuff and elderberries, I wanted to share a few facts on elderberries and why they're so effective at warding off cold, flu, and other viruses, and why it's such a loved remedy in the homes of herbalists. And hopefully one day we'll get into everybody's home again, because really we need to make this whole herbalism thing spread like wildflowers, right? Anyways, there have been several studies that show elderberries to be incredibly effective at warding off over 10 different flu viruses. That's a lot of viruses to be able to fight off. Unfortunately, there's not enough money in elderberry farming to make them test for anything related to COVID these days. So don't go getting any crazy or funny ideas there. There's also been quite a few studies on people that had the flu, and the study showed that when they used elderberries, their symptoms went away in 2 to 3 days, where the people that took the placebo took 6 to 8 days to get better. Yes, please, because being sick sucks. Being sick for a week plus sucks even more. Am I right? So another way that elder rocks is that it helps your body to rid itself of waste through urination and sweating. It's one of the reasons why it's so effective against cold and flu and other general respiratory problems, because it releases the waste. And inside the berry, there's a bunch of juice. Well, a bunch for such a teeny tiny berry. But that elderberry juice contains high amounts of flavonoids called anthocyanins, which are really just very strong antioxidants. And these anthocyanins produce cytokines. Cytokines are these little protein messengers that help to boost the immune system by basically sending out an announcement to the immune cells that there is a pathogen or foreign invader, and it's on the prowl in your body, and it's time to build up that immune army and fight it off. It is so cool the way our bodies work with plants and the way the plants work with us. Ooh. And speaking of cool, elderberries are also very high in vitamin C, which actually happens to increase the antioxidant effect as a bonus. And it's been shown that these elderberries seem to be able to strengthen the cell membranes or the cell wall, and it actually prevents the viruses from being able to poke through the cell wall and get you sick. And they're an awesome expectorant, which is really great when you've got a cough. It helps you get all that icky stuff up and out of your body. Sweet, right? I think so. So yeah, that's just some of the reasons that elderberries are so greatly loved in the herbal community and beyond. And I imagine you're here because you'd love to keep the sickness out of your house as much as possible too. So with that, I quit with all the scientific herb nerd stuff, and I want to share with you one of my basic elderberry syrup recipes. Of course, I do also want to note, if you don't have the things for the recipe on hand, I also have a super easy DIY elderberry syrup kit over at mountainmells.com. I'll link to that in the show notes, but I just want you to know that it's available. It's crazy easy. You just basically open a compostable bag, dump the contents of the bag into 4 cups of boiling water, simmer it, strain it, add some really good honey. But for those of you that really want to make your own, because really it's pretty fun, or maybe you went out and harvested your own berries, but you only did it with proper plant ID, right? Anyways, here's my basic recipe to make your own elderberry syrup. You want about 1.5 cups freshly picked or frozen berries, or you can substitute 3/4 cups of dried organic elderberries, 3.25 cups of water, 1.25 cups of honey. Go for the raw local honey if available, because it does have some great antimicrobial and antibacterial and antiviral properties. Plus, it's an excellent preservative. Get a 3-inch cinnamon stick or two, 3 to 4 whole cloves, 1 tablespoon of dried ginger root, or you can do 2 tablespoons of fresh grated ginger rhizome, actually. You're gonna combine everything but the honey and bring the mixture to a boil. Reduce the heat, slowly simmer for about 20 minutes to an hour, and then you wanna use like a potato masher or anything else that you can crush with to crush the berries and set it aside to cool for just a few minutes. Then strain that concoction, compost all the solid stuff, and add honey to the mixture until it dissolves. Voila! You have now made your very own elderberry syrup. This will make about 4 cups of syrup. You can then store it in your refrigerator for about 8 weeks. You can freeze it in ice cube trays so it stores longer, and you can take it out as needed, basically in a dosage. So speaking of dosage, the standard dose would be about about a half teaspoon to 1 teaspoon for kids under 12, and about a half tablespoon to 1 tablespoon for adults. You can take it daily during cold and flu season as a preventative, and you can also take it for a week, then take it off for a week, and repeat that process. If you do happen to get sick, take the normal dose I just mentioned every 2 to 3 hours instead of once a day until symptoms disappear. And just remember that it is okay to work with your healthcare practitioner in this. So if you are sick or anything in a major way, do work with somebody. And also, quick reminder, if the recipe isn't available for you, you can definitely get it from mountainmells.com. I do have that DIY kit and it's a lot better. You get about 5 times the amount you would in a bottle from the store, which is like 20 bucks. And you get like this 4 ounce little bottle. So anyways, there are a ton of ways you can adapt this recipe and you can make it your own based upon what's going on with you, how your taste buds like things and such. So if you want to get in touch with the other herbs you can add to your syrup and really make this elderberry syrup your elderberry syrup, I have a download over at theherbalistpath.com/elderberry syrup recipe. I'll link below. When you're exploring those herbs, do keep in mind that the more dense herbs, the roots, the barks, and the berries, they need to be simmered for a longer amount of time. Whereas when you're working with delicate herbs like flowers and leaves, those should go in at the end of the process when you're in the cool down process, so you don't ruin the medicinal constituents there. So no matter what you do, make sure you're having fun and saving money as you make your own elderberry syrup. And if this video is valuable to you, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, because really, it's time we make this world a better place. And one great way we can do that is by making herbalism spread like wildflowers.